Kingfish.
Oh, what's the matter?
Look, Kingfish, I was just looking at the television set in the music store window down the street, and guess who's on?
Who, Andy?
Madam Queen.
Madam Queen? On television?
Yeah.
Why didn't they think they could squeeze her in a 17-inch screen? This I got to see. Come on, Andy. Yeah, I turn her on here.
They're having an amateur singing contest, and she's one of the finalists.
Well, now we see what happens. Brahms' lullaby, huh?
Yeah. I say, Kingfish, is baby supposed to sleep to that kind of music?
Well, I guess they can. That Brahms could.
Personally, I think it'd be better for waking them up.
Now, Madam Queen, who sang Chloe.
Look, Andy. Here come Madam Queen.
Yeah.
Ain't no chain can bind you. If you live, I'll find you. For love is calling me. I've got to go where you are.
Our applause meter shows Madam Queen to be the winner.
Hey, Andy, that old gal ain't too bad there.
Yeah, she won this contest in a breeze.
Congratulations, Madam Queen.
Thank you.
It is my pleasure to award you this $50 government bond.
Wonderful.
And also a 12-month singing course at the studio of that great vocal teacher, Mr. Edward Mason.
Oh, my, that's grand.
And something else I know you'll be interested in. Since your rendition of Chloe up earlier in the program, we have received 8 phone calls offering you singing engagements at various places.
Oh, I'm so happy. That thank you so much.
Different engagements. Yeah. You know, Andy, it just recurred to me, being how me and you and great music lovers, this is a voice that we should give to the world.
Yeah, well, that's all right with me.
You know, Andy, it's up to me and you to get Madam Queen to sign us up as her managers.
Yeah, well, how much we got to get?
Oh, well, don't make no difference what she gets. All we gonna get is a measly 50% of the box office receipts.
50% of the receipts? Well, I thought we was doing this because we was music lovers.
Oh, yeah, Andy. But there ain't a music lover in town to get less than 50%. You see, that's the standard rate for music loving.
Well, I guess it's okay, Kingfish.
Andy, I'm gonna drop a management contract, and tomorrow, me and you is going up to see Madam Queen. Oh, wait a minute. Now, wait, Andy, before we go in to see Madam Queen, how's your relationship here? Is it friendly or antagonistic?
Oh, we're still on a friendly basis. You'll see her every once in a while.
Oh, good.
Andy Brown and Kingfish.
Hello, Madam Queen.
How do you do there?
Oh, it's so nice to see you. Come on in.
Madam Queen, we were just passing by, and we thought we'd stop in to congratulate you on your performance last night.
Oh, so many of my old friends have been dropping around after seeing you on television. Come on, sit down.
Yeah, thank you. Well, Madam Queen, you're a big celebrity now, and I'm crazy about your voice. I ain't heard no power like that since down on the farm, where my uncle used to call in the hogs.
Oh, I'm so excited about the whole thing. You know, one of the prizes is a year's free instruction with a vocal coach. And I just came from my first lesson this morning with Mr. Mason.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's hear what he learned you.
All right. It goes like this. From low C to high C. Do, 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 do.
That sounds fine in here, Madam Queen, but I don't think the public going to pay top prices for 3 hours of gargling.
Oh, both of them exercise.
Oh, the ears are that fine, that different. Now, Madam Queen, getting right down to business, the reason why me and Andy is here is to offer you our personal service.
Yeah.
Personal services?
Yeah, now, while you're away, blatant away on your engagement, you got to have somebody to look after your affairs. And I done got a managing contract all drawn up here. It's the standard operatic concert form as approved by Cap Calloway. I meet you one of the high spots. Me, George Kingfish Stevens, and he, Andrew H. Brown, agree to personal manage the singing career of one Madam Queen for a nominal, reasonable chicken feed sum of 50% of the take.
Yeah, that's the standard rate.
Furthermore, if by any chance there's any loophole in this contract, the music lovers, namely Brown and Stevens, done reserve the right to plug them up within 10 years. So now, you sign right there, we'll sign right under you.
Well, there's one thing. Mr. Mason, my vocal coach, advised me that there'd be probably a half a dozen managers hanging around like vultures trying to sign me up. And he told me not to sign with anybody.
Oh, he did, huh?
He doesn't think that I'm ready for any engagements for at least a year until my studies are completed.
Well, he got on nerve.
Yeah, why don't he just take care of his end of the thing and let us vultures take care of our end?
Well, he's got my career in mind, and I'm going to do whatever he says.
Come on, Andy, let's get on out of here.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Madam Queen.
Goodbye, Kingfish.
Well, goodbye, Madam Queen.
Nice seeing you again, Andy.
Yeah, well, nice seeing you, too.
I thought a lot about you, Andy, ever since that last date.
Yeah, remember how romantic it was out on that boat?
Mm-hmm.
Remember when I put my arms around you and called you my cutie pie?
Mm-hmm. And I pinched your cheek and called you my little apple dumpling.
Yeah. Called you my little cream puff.
I'm certainly glad I had a fiddler's powder before I come up here. Come on, Andy.
Yeah, goodbye, Madam.
Goodbye, Andy.
Look, Andy, we in trouble here. And as long as Madam Queen takes advice from this fella Mason, ain't nobody gonna make a dime on this deal.
Yeah, making her take lessons for a year is gonna put a crimp in the whole plan. What you think we ought to do, Kingfish?
Andy, we'll go up and see this fella Mason and tell him to keep his nose on his side of the fence. After all, he's only Madam Queen's teacher.
Yeah, we're gonna be the managers.
Right. And if you get nasty about it, we are liable to take over the teaching end too.
Yeah.
Andy, you know anything about music?
Well, about 10 years ago, I sent off a correspondence course playing the banjo.
Well, that's something.
Well, the only thing is, they sent me the piccolo lesson by mistake. And for the first 3 weeks, I was trying to blow into a banjo.
Come on. Let's go.
Yeah. What are you singing, Kingfish?
Yeah, I don't know exactly. But it sounds like one of them famous operas, Wriggle and Let Go or something like that.
You don't let go too easy, do it.
Come on, let's go in, Andy.
Yes?
How do you do there? My name is Stevens, and this is Mr. Brown. And we're up here to see you regarding Madam Queen's career.
Won't you come in?
Yeah.
Sit down, gentlemen.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, what's this about Madam Queen's career?
Well, now, to get right to the point, me and Mr. Brown here is interested in giving this beautiful voice to the world without delay.
Yeah.
Well, it just so happens that Madam Queen's voice is not yet ready.
What you mean it ain't ready yet?
Well, to put it simply, her chest tones suffer from faulty diaphragmatic breathing. And instead of attacking a vibrato with brilliance, she has a tendency to modulate into a change of phrasing which causes her diction to become labial rather than enunciatory or forensic.
Yeah, well, let's get back to Madam Queen's singing.
Yeah, let's stick to the subject.
I was simply trying to point out that instead of attacking an arpeggio with brilliance and intonation, she lapses into a glissando, which of course leads to her failure to recognize the necessary crescendo for a coda.
Mr. Mason, we'd like for you to stick to the teaching. Me and Mr. Brown here will handle the managing.
You know, it's obvious to me that you're just interested in rushing Madam Queen's career for your own selfish purposes. Fortunately, she's taking advice from me, and she isn't going to accept any engagements for at least a year, maybe more. Her voice is too valuable to be tampered with. That's final.
Good day, gentlemen.
You just wait until Cab Calloway hear about this.
Yeah.
And that Calhoun is the situation up to date.
You say when you went up to see this fellow Mason, he called you a couple of chiselers, huh?
That's right.
Well, you can say one thing about the guy. He's a good judge of character.
Calhoun, I thank you to keep your insinuenda to yourself.
But it looks to me like this fella Mason done Svengotted himself in the top spot with Madam Queen. She ain't gonna do nothing without his advice.
Look, Calhoun, this thing is too big to let drop. She gonna be making a fortune for years to come. And whoever's managing her gonna be right on the bandwagon.
Well, I can't think of nothing you can do.
Calhoun, you gotta think of something. There's a fortune at stake here.
All right, then, let me think. You know, this whole thing size up to me like a struggle for power. Now, what you gotta do is dethrone this guy and put a new power in control.
Yeah.
Kingfish, can I speak with you for a second?
Yeah, sure, Calhoun.
What? It's the only thing you can do.
Calhoun, that's too drastic. I just couldn't see that happen.
Well, it's your only way out.
Well, just like you say, I guess that's the way it's gotta be. Andy, let me congratulate you on your forthcoming marriage to Madam Queen.
Yeah. Hey, wait a minute. What's going on here? What happened?
Now, don't get excited, Andy. This is one of them rare opportunities that only happen once in a lifetime.
Oh, no. I ain't gonna marry Madam Queen. I ain't been marrying her for the past 20 years, and that's how it's gonna stay.
Look, Andy, do you realize what it means to be married to a great concert artist? Why, you and her will be like Pons and Castellanes, London Fontaine, Abbott and Costello.
Don't you see, Andy? You'll be living the life of luxury. While Madam Queen is going all over the country blating her lungs out, you and the Kingfish will be sitting at home, managing her.
Yeah, but why does I have to marry her to manage her?
Look, Andy, as Madam Queen's husband, you'll be the closest one to her, and you can get rid of that Mason just by saying the word.
Oh, can I?
Yeah, and on top of that, as Madam Queen's husband, why, you're entitled to 50% of everything she has under the community property law.
Yes?
Oh, man, yes.
Oh, certainly. And now that she's going to make a living singing through them beautiful pipes she got, Andy, after you are married, one of them pipes is yours.
Yeah, but where did you come in on all this?
Well, like I say, Andy, according to the community property law, when you married, you get 50% of Madam Queen. By me and you being partners, I get 50% of you. And that's community property all the way around.
Yeah, but you got a better deal than I is.
What do you mean, Andy?
Well, you don't have to kiss me goodnight.
Andy, what do you think?
I guess it's all right. After all, being married to a big concert singer and me only one of her pipes might be all right.
Now, Andy, I want you to go in there and propose. And from the way you two are talking the other day, I know she's going to accept. Now, here's the diamond engagement ring right here, Andy.
Look, Kingfish, there must be some other way for us to get to be Madam Queen's managers.
Now, look, Andy, you promised to go through with this. Now, we each got $125 invested in this here ring. Now, this ain't no time to weaken. Now, go on in there and propose.
Oh, all right. Hiya, Madam Green. I'm sorry I'm a little late.
Oh, that's all right. Come on in and have a seat.
Thank you.
Now, you were telling me on the phone that there was something important you wanted to say to me.
Yeah, I did, didn't I?
Yes.
Well, I tell you, Madam Green, me and you has known each other a long time.
Yeah, that's right, Andy.
After all, you know what kind of a fella I is. I know what kind of a woman you is.
Yes.
We like the same thing.
Yes, yes.
So in view of the fact that we is both patable, I want to ask you this very important question.
What is it, Andy?
Madam Queen, would you, would you give me a glass of water, please?
Yes, of course, Andy.
The tummy had a hook in her mouth and didn't gather.
Here you are, Andy.
Oh, thanks.
Now, you were saying that there's something important you wanted to ask me?
Oh, yeah. Well, like I say, Madam Queen, neither one of us is kids no more, and we both know our own minds. And like the poet said, ain't nothing nicer than true love between mutual souls. So I think it's only fitting and proper for me to ask you this important question.
What, Andy, what?
Would you give me another glass of water, please?
Why do they have to go dry at a time like this?
Now, what were you saying?
Well, knowing how important it is for a person to have companionship,
Companionship, yes.
Whatever happened to that cocker spaniel you had?
Andy, stop. You want to ask me something important, or don't you?
Yes, I does, Madam Queen.
Well, what is it?
Will you marry me?
Oh! Of course I'll marry you, Andy.
Well, congratulations to you, too. I just happened to be walking down the hall when I heard the good news.
Oh, I know we're going to be so happy.
Yeah, and I know that you two are going to have a great fiscal career together. I do never think jointly, community property and all that stuff.
Oh, I almost forgot the most important thing of all.
Oh, a diamond engagement ring. And I've waited so long for this to happen. Now, finally, we're going to be one. Oh, I'm so choked up, I can hardly utter a sound.
Yeah, well, wait a minute. You ain't losing your voice or nothing, is you?
Oh.
Well, the thing to do is set the knuckles as soon as possible so we can get things to rolling here.
Well, the sooner the better for me.
Well, the thing to do is start the wedding and the fiscal period at the same time.
Yeah, well, I'll talk to you about the marriage in the morning. We're going over and get everything all set up.
All right, Andy. And this is the happiest day of my life.
So, after all these years, Andy, you're finally going to marry Madam Queen.
Yeah, the wedding's all set for tomorrow, but the Lenox Avenue wedding manor.
Well, Andy, I know you and Madam Queen have had a lot of ups and downs. Mm-hmm. So now, you sure you're doing the right thing, ain't you?
Oh, I'm positive, Amos.
Well, I don't know. The whole thing don't sound exactly right to me. Now, just because she's going to be a big singer, you're going to marry her. The whole thing sounds kind of fishy to me, Andy. Kingfishy.
Yeah, well, you know, he's involved in the thing, too. He put up half the money for the engagement ring.
Yeah, I understand you give her a big ring, all right.
Oh, yeah. Me and the Kingfish spent $250 on the thing. We didn't want to take a chance on those slip-ups.
Well, Andy, all I can say is I sure hope everything works out all right and that you are sincere about really wanting to make a go of this thing.
Yeah.
Hello, Boyd.
Hi, Kingfish.
Andy, I've been out working like a beaver.
Oh, you is, huh?
Yeah, I've been out signing up a few contracts for Madam Queen.
Oh, starting the ball rolling already.
Oh, yeah. She's going to open at the Blue Gardena in Jersey City on your wedding night.
On the wedding night?
Mm-hmm. Going to do 8 shows tonight, and she's going to be there for 2 weeks.
I was afraid it was going to be something like this. I know what you're doing is wrong, but I guess there ain't nothing much I can do about it. So long, fellas.
That Amos, always trying to make sense at the wrong time.
Yeah. But say, Kingfish, tell me more about this schedule you got worked up for Madam Queen.
Well, Andy, I've been giving it a lot of thought about the type of music that I'm going to have her sing. So I decided that I'm going to have her mix them up so they know she's versatile.
Yeah, that's right. Show them everything.
Yeah. So I think I'm going to have her start off with a popular tune like Stardust or something like that.
Yeah, that's always good.
Then we're going to follow up with something like Beethoven's Fifth Symphony.
That sounds good. Everybody knows that one. The only thing is that these sympathies don't have no words to them.
Well, Andy, I'm going to let her hum it, see? And then, right after Beethoven, I'm gonna have a smack 'em down with the flight of the bumblebee.
That one got words, or is she gonna have to buzz it?
Well, beat a number so fast they won't know what it's all about, no how.
Yeah, well, the whole thing sounds great, Kingfish. And that money we spent for that engagement ring gonna pay off big.
Oh, yeah, Andy. The way I got her booked, right after the marriage, we're gonna have our investment back before you have to kiss her goodnight.
Yeah, everything sounds great, Kingfish.
Yeah, like the trainer said, when he seen Seabiscuit run around the track the first time, we really got ourselves a nag here.
Well, this is indeed a surprise. You're getting married.
Oh, it all happened very suddenly.
I see. You know, of course, that your fiancé was up here with a Mr. Stevens. They seemed very anxious to have you go out and start singing immediately.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Now look, Madam Queen, whom you marry is your business. But you have a brilliant career ahead of you, and I don't think it should be placed in the hands of anybody inexperienced.
Well, I agree with you, Mr. Mason. And if Andy Brown thinks he's going to live off my income, he's sadly mistaken. Once we're married, he's going to have to go to work just like any other husband.
Now, as we discussed it, Madam Queen, I still think it would be wise for you to let me handle your singing career. I have papers drawn up that will give me exclusive right to handle you.
And that's just the way I want it, Mr. Mason. I'll sign the papers.
Good. I know it'll be a very successful relationship.
And I do hope that you'll be able to come to the wedding. You know, it'll be at the Lennox Avenue Wedding Manor. It's 4 tomorrow.
Don't worry. I'll make it a point to be there.
Good.
Ain't a big Mr. Mason.
How are you?
Oh, just fine. And it seems like me and Mr. Brown had the situation well in hand after all. Matter of fact, we are arranging an engagement for her right now.
What?
That's right.
Well, I think you're a little premature. It just so happens that yesterday, Madam Queen signed a contract with me for exclusive management.
Well,
oh, what? That's right. I have the contract right here.
He done signed a contract with this fella Mason, and we are out.
Holy smoke. It's a good thing you found out in time. I'd have been married to her with no income. What are we going to do, Kingfish? Well, I tell you one thing. I ain't going to marry no nightingale and let some other guy get all the birds seed.
Andy, I don't know what if I blame you.
Come on, let's get out of here. How come they ain't got no windows in this place?
You don't think this is the first time this ever happened, do you?
Well, let's keep out.
Instead of a roadblock here.
Let's get out that side door.
Andy Brown, come back here.
Amos, you is right. Whenever you try to do something that ain't right, it never works out.
Yeah, well, I tried to warn you, Andy, but you just wouldn't listen.
Yeah. Tell me and the Kingfish is out $250 on that engagement ring. And I remember the first time I was engaged to Madam Queen, I gave her a cigarette lighter for $75 as an engagement present.
Yeah, well, that's the way it is, all right.
Yeah. You know, Amos, this whole thing is going to teach me a lesson.
Well, that's good. I'm glad to hear it, son.
Yeah, from now on, I'm going to be smart. I'm going to get married before I get engaged.